Armenian and Azeri forces fought new clashes on Friday, defying hopes of ending nearly 3 weeks of fighting over the Nagorno-Karabakh enclave, and U.S. Secretary of State Mike Pompeo blamed Turkey for inflaming the situation by arming the Azeris. The worst outbreak of violence in the South Caucasus since Armenia and Azerbaijan went to war over the enclave in the 1990s, the fighting risks creating a humanitarian disaster, especially if it draws in Russia and Turkey. Nagorno-Karabakh is internationally recognized as part of Azerbaijan but populated and governed by ethnic Armenians. Turkey has increased military exports sixfold this year to its close ally Azerbaijan. Russia is close to both sides but has a defense pact with Armenia. News agency RIA reported the Russian Navy had started planned military exercises in the Caspian Sea. There were further signs on Friday that a Russian brokered ceasefire agreed last Saturday to allow the sides to swap detainees, and the bodies of those killed had all but broken down. Armenia and Azerbaijan each accused the other of launching attacks, and each said it had the upper hand. Armenian Defense Ministry official Artsron Hovhannisyan said Azerbaijan had conducted artillery bombardments of Nagorno-Karabakh from the north, with total disregard for the humanitarian truce. He added that Azeri forces had been repelled and had suffered significant losses. Azerbaijan's defense ministry said Nagorno-Karabakh forces had been forced to retreat and Azeri forces retained the advantage along the line of contact that divides the sides. Reuters could not independently verify the reports. Baku also accused Yerevan of a missile attack on Ordubad in Nakhchivan Autonomous Province, a region which belongs to Azerbaijan but is surrounded by Armenia and Iran. Armenia denied such an attack. The Nagorno-Karabakh Defense Ministry reported 29 more military casualties, bringing to 633 the number of servicemen killed since fighting broke out on September 27. Azerbaijan does not disclose military casualties. The Azeri Prosecutor General's office said 47 civilians had been killed and 222 wounded. The hostilities, close to pipelines in Azerbaijan that carry gas and oil to global markets, are stoking concern in Europe and the United States that Turkey and Russia, already at loggerheads over Syria and Libya, will be dragged in. Pompeo said Turkey had worsened the conflict by providing resources to Azerbaijan. A diplomatic resolution was needed, rather than third-party countries coming in to lend their firepower to what is already a powder keg of a situation, he said in an interview with broadcaster WSB Atlanta. Ankara accuses Armenia of illegally occupying Azeri territory. Armenia says Turkey has encouraged Azerbaijan to pursue a military solution to the conflict, putting Armenian civilians in danger. Armenia's foreign ministry said Foreign Minister Zohar Avnitskanyan had spoken by phone with United Nations Secretary General Antonio Guterres, asking the international community to neutralize Azeri actions which he said posed an existential danger of the people of Nagorno-Karabakh.